At a recent robotics competition in Boston, Steve Wozniak, the co-founder of Apple, was one of the judges. We caught up with him and asked him some questions on a variety of topics.
So tell me a little bit about why you're involved in this competition.
Oh, I got involved by accident, being friends with Dean Kamen, who started the whole first thing and all that. And I was so inspired by the meaning, the emphasis on technology and technologists feeling respected and feeling good about what they do. And so I got pulled in, and every year that I've done it, every single event I've ever been to, judging, working hard, I feel it's the best thing I do with my time ever.
What do you think about the students' ingenuity in this competition?
Well, here in Boston, there's actually differences between different regionals. Here in Boston, I'm seeing some incredibly creative and good machine applications. This time, some of us judges judge the technical parts of the machines. Some of us judge the team parts, what makes the people work well together as a team in their school. I'm judging teams this time, but I'm just over impressed with the quality of the robots.
And if we could diverge a little bit, I want to ask you a little bit about technology in the world. What can the U.S. do to either maintain or regain its edge in the world in terms of technology?
Well, in the first place, you need a lot of the aspects that lead not necessarily directly to engineering. There are a lot of types of engineering that are needed, you know, well, obviously to build houses and bridges, but there's this inventor aspect. Where does the inventor come from? To try something other people have never done. If you don't have the skills from your schooling, from your education, from being involved in groups like TURST, how are you ever going to hook a bunch of things together, bolt some motors together, hook some wires up, write some programs? Oh my God, it works, and come up with a great new device that people want. You've really got to leave that innovation, the ability for people to innovate and get somewhere. And really, it means people that are broadly trained in a lot of areas, from mechanical to electrical to programming, that can put together these sort of devices for the future.
Do you think that the personal computer will ever become obsolete in favor of web-based applications or mobile devices?
Personal computer, it's very hard to predict. Everything in theory becomes obsolete sometime, and we just think the results. But you know what? The computer really hasn't changed much since it was first conceived of a couple hundred years ago, the basic methods of computing. And it's tough to replace it because the computer does so many things for so little money. Yeah, and what would you suggest replacing it with? It's just another computer. We'd just change the name. The thing that really changes is how we interface with the computer. We used to type long, complicated text lines, and now we have mouses and graphics, and now we touch screens and move things around. So our interface with the computer is becoming more natural. Voice is the way you and I speak. We're two computers, if you think about it. And it's easy to make a computer that's as intelligent as a human. It's called a baby.
Talking about touch screens, do you use an Apple iPhone?
I do use an Apple iPhone, and I really admire it, and I love it for what it is. And there are some things that it doesn't do perfectly. I'm an engineer, so I make the trade-offs, and I use more than one phone. I know a whole bunch of gadget freaks that like to carry a lot of gadgets, but the iPhone is just my favorite, and I'm looking forward to more and more applications coming out on it from the general public. What other people think of that even a company doesn't that creates the product is what amazes me. Young kids just come up with ideas that go so far beyond what you ever imagined a game would be, for example. Or building some of the Wii-like, motion sensing. It's just wonderful.
And what do you think about Apple?
I think Apple is just so well managed. I just admire the type of products the company puts out. Nothing's ever 100%, but I am so glad to be associated with that company, and I can't say that about very many companies in the world. That's like the star, the shining star of the world almost, for leading us to a new future. Part of the future is a lot of companies try to avoid getting to that day when a lot of our standard media, like television shows and music, is all coming over the internet. And Apple's taken the most forward steps to getting to what the future's likely to be.
And one last question. Doing what you do today, what do you look for in successful technology companies? What makes a company successful?
Well, it does actually boil down to the people. But generally, you can have some very bright, creative people with ideas that know how to turn those ideas into real products, but also other people that know where the engineering, what effect it has on real life and real, marketing. The marketing side of things is often forgotten by an engineer who's so clever about what they can do, they don't stop and think, is it really worth something? So somebody who can kind of do the overview is the most thing. So the sort of people that are involved in a company in the various, departments that almost any company needs. Operations, which is getting things made, everything counting, you definitely need some kind of president. You always need somebody that drives the company in the right direction for the shareholders and all. You need good engineering. You better have the tops, in my mind, and marketing to study what people want and will use and how you can affect them positively. So you need it all, and it's really the group.
And just tell me a little bit about what you've been doing these days other than First Robotics, your favorite thing is that.
I've been on a lot of like nonprofit boards because I like to be a nonprofit person. I'm on some boards of small startup companies. I love it when young people, like we see here at First, have an idea and they want to start a company. I'll sit down and just advise them or, you know, give them some advice or join their board because that's my favorite thing in life, doing what Steve Jobs and I did back when we were in our young 20s and had no money. And I'm on some companies with technology, some are even non-technology. I'm very interested in green building materials because that's very popular nowadays. And it's a very tough thing to do. People think, oh, there's a few technologies that are very green. And the final answer is if they're green or not. It's difficult to tell sometimes.
Talking about Apple's chief competition, Microsoft, Bill Gates is leaving, stepping down his daily activities. Any thoughts on that? Or?
No, I don't expect Microsoft to change a lot. I think Bill Gates is still so well respected that he'll have just about the same role that he had before, de facto. Yeah, I really do appreciate the fact that he can, some point in his life, get out and maybe do some other things that he wants to do and be a person, you know, who can have some of the experiences normal people have. He can do whatever he wants. You know, go visit some parts of the world. I really admire him for his, you know, his entrepreneurship and all that. I just wish he built better computers, but there's different sides to that story.
Great. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
Oh, no. I mean, this is just, it's so great. Boston's almost like a second city to me. I really love the city. So great to be here at the Boston Regional at First. I travel around, go to a lot of cities and judge different regionals, and it's just always the greatest experience right here. I can't even say some of the things I know that are coming up.
Great. I appreciate it. Appreciate your time.
Thanks.